the amount of solute in the solvent. And there are different types of formulas according to the mass and volume of the solution. And these are the formulas, that is mass by mass percentage of a solution. That is mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. That is mass of a solution comes of mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Both solute and solvent masses is equal to mass of solution. And according to volume, mass by volume percentage of a solution. That is mass of a solute by volume of solution into 100. The volume of solution is both solvent and solute. And therefore, these are used according to the solid solution and liquid solution, right? For liquid solutions, we will be taking volume, and for solid solutions, we will be taking mass as a unit. And let us see one example for getting more clarity on these solution formulas. That is, when we take 40 grams of salt in 320 grams of water, then 320 grams of water will be acting as solvent because it is of larger quantity, and 40 grams of salt will be acting as solute because it is of lesser quantity. Now, the mass of solution will be both 40 grams plus 320 grams of water. That is equals to 360 grams of, this is the mass of solution. And the mass of solute is 40 grams. Then we will be dividing according to the formula, that is mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Mass of solute is 40 divided by mass of solution, that is 320 plus 40 equals to 360. 40 by 360 into 100, it will be leading to 11.1%. This is the solution percentage of salt water. Thus, we can calculate the percentages according to mass and volume for a solution. Now let us see what is a suspension. Previously we have seen a solution is a homogeneous mixture. Now a suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. It is a non-homogeneous system. That means it is constituted of different particles. Now let us see that solids in liquids. Whatever solid matters or solid particles that are dissolved in liquids, it is known as a non-homogeneous system. And this is known as suspensions. Now let us see the definition of a suspension. A suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particles do not dissolve but remain suspended throughout the bulk of a medium. That means, for example, let us take some stones, right, that are known as solid matter, right? When it is kept in water, it will not be dissolved but it will settle down in the water. That means they are suspended under layer of water. That means it is known as suspension and not dissolvation. That is, it is not dissolved but they are suspended below. So this is known as suspension. And the word suspension thus derived a non-homogeneous system because they are not of same matter and they are not of same particles and they are not of same chemical properties. Hence, these are known as non-homogeneous or heterogeneous mixtures or suspensions. And let us see the properties of suspension or heterogeneous solutions. That is, it is a heterogeneous mixture and it is non-homogeneous system, and all the particles we can see through our naked eye because those particles are very large in size and therefore it is not dissolved. And so the scattered beam of light, that means the path of the light which travels through the solute, can be visible. In homogeneous systems, we cannot see the path of light, but in suspensions, that is heterogeneous solutions, we can see the path of the light because due to scattered beam of light which is traveling through the solute particles. And the fourth point is solute will settle down because the solute is undissolved state and it is settled down in the solution. Therefore, this is known as unstable solution, whereas homogeneous solution is known as stable solution. The four properties of suspension are heterogeneous mixture. We can see them in naked eye and we can see the path of the light and we can see the solutions are settled down. The solute particles in the solution will be settled down. That is known as unstable solution. Previously we have seen homogeneous solution, heterogeneous solution, and there is one more other solution that is known as colloidal solution. What is a colloidal solution? The particles of E. coli are uniformly spread throughout the solution. That means the substance or the any matter consists of a particles are uniformly spread over the solvent. That means, for example, take water and milk. Water is solvent and milk is solute, right? And milk is spread uniformly over water. We cannot separate water and milk when they are mixed up, right? That is known as colloidal solution. We will think that colloidal solution is also a homogeneous solution because it is having same properties, and means it is combined with one substance, right? But homogeneous substance is not, because a colloidal solution is not a homogeneous substance or not a homogeneous solution because it is consisting of two different substances or two different particles with different chemical properties. For example, water has different chemical properties while compared to milk. Therefore, a colloidal solution is known as a heterogeneous solution only. Therefore, due to the relativity of smaller size of particles as compared to heterogeneous solution particles have bigger size compared to colloidal solution particles, and therefore we will feel as if we assume that they are homogeneous, but they are not homogeneous, and we cannot see them with naked eye because these are so minor particles like homogeneous, so we cannot see them also with our naked eye, but as compared with heterogeneous we will be seeing them with our naked eye and scatter a beam of light. That means the light path cannot be visible, but the scattering of beam is in a Tyndall effect form. That means the scientist who is known as Tyndall has discovered this effect, that is therefore named as Tyndall effect, which means that, for example, take a deep forest. During the morning sunrise, the rays of sun falls through the deep forest into the land in the deep forest. The rays and all the sparkings of light, or for example, take a hole in a room, and if you project a torch through that hole, the beam what is produced through that hole is also known as Tyndall effect, that Tyndall effect of light. This is the effect which is known as Tyndall effect of light, and this effect is produced in colloidal solutions only, and this is known as Tyndall effect in colloidal solutions. For example, take copper sulfate solution. This copper sulfate solution is a heterogeneous solution, and whereas water and milk solution is a colloidal solution, which is a good example for it, and we can understand that those particles are in smaller size and are very uniformly spread throughout the surface of the solvent.